over the course of these different retreats, the thought that comes to my mind is cooked frogs. So, how do you cook a frog? you put them in the water and turn up the heat slowly. and I feel like I've been, is it just me or is it getting warm in here? So over the course of these retreats, I feel like I've been just very gently moved along. But it's like that has really intensified something for me. And really, it's felt like I've got cracked open. And it's afforded the opportunity for a real heart open.
Thank you, Will. Thank you. Yeah, I feel... like if we all just had a little switch on our heart, like I've got a little microphone here and it's like a little toggle switch. And, you know, we could say that most of us, we've just lived most of our lifetimes where it's clicked over in Newtonian mode. And all Jesus wants us to do is click into quantum. He just wants us to click the little toggle switch. You know, it's like, you are thinking of relationships in linear terms. That's where all your struggles come in, is you think the word relationship and you think bodies and you think time. It's you're in Newtonian. You're in empirical Newtonian. Everything ever since Isaac Newton started putting all this down, you know, and telling us how the world universe was and false cause effect, and for every action there's a reaction, and all the stuff we learned in science, all the stuff we learned about biology, all the stuff we learned about medicine, all the stuff we learned about relationships, families, churches, society in general, it's all Newtonian. And all Jesus is saying is just flip the switch. You need to go quantum. Will was just talking about how powerful those clips were. You know, isn't it great how Jason can play a clip and you can kind of really give yourself over to the clip, you know? You let go of all your thoughts of who you are, where you are, and you really just absorb in that, we'll say, 2-minute clip. You're in quantum. You're just like, ooh, here it is. A little slice here, 2 minutes, gonna be fun. What's gonna happen? What's the spirit gonna show me in the next 2 minutes? The thing I discovered was the ego believes that it needs a substitute for divine love, a substitute for eternity. So it makes up linear time. And it's like I used a spaghetti strand one time. Some of you have seen it, where we're living our life as if it's this long spaghetti noodle. And Jesus, again, wants us to turn it on its angle and come back and look at it right from the point. So it's no longer linear. Just come back to this moment. Jesus doesn't want to think of our projects in a linear way. As soon as you think of a project in a linear way, you're in this kind of stagnant, okay, I've got to personally perform, I've got to do my part, or I'll feel guilty. We got to get to the end of it too. And all of a sudden, the project is stagnant. When you think of the relationship in linear terms, it gets stagnant. When you think of jobs, careers in linear terms, stagnant, because we're eternal beings and we were never designed for time. We were never designed for time. Time is the problem. And so all I'm saying is I invite everybody to just click the little toggle switch. It doesn't matter. So you've lived 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70 years with the toggle over there on Newtonian, pop it in there. Just pop it into some quantum. Everything we're perceiving here is all this joy is because we've just been willing to just go into the experience together, all 100 and some of us. We just clicking it into quantum. Quantum says everything's connected. Quantum focuses on the present moment. Quantum says everything that you perceive in the whole world is a reflection of your mind, your consciousness. And you don't have to see it in a linear, this event comes before this event comes before this and this. when we seemed to fall from grace, we went from pure, absolute, eternal love and joy into, talk about a fish out of water. We were a spirit out of context, a spirit out of eternity. It's crazy, crazy thing. And so everybody who's, like Will was talking about relationships and how intense it's been, is because we're looking for continuity in time. And what Jesus showed me was that you can't find it. You will never find continuity in time. It's all broken pieces. It's like, what are those things? Kaleidoscopes. You know, when you turn the kaleidoscopes and all the colors and sharp, jagged images, you can keep turning the kaleidoscope, but you're never going to find continuity in time. You have to click the switch over to quantum. You've got to take that, remember that show, Quantum Leap? You've got to take the quantum leap to find continuity, to find happiness. At first, the ego will be very discouraged. It will say, oh, no, no, you can find, you can find continuity in time. But none of us have ever been able to find continuity in time. It's all broken pieces. It's like we're not going to find it from that linear perspective. You're not going to find continuity on the noodle. It's good to just give up the noodle, you know, and say, I have to switch gears here. I'm not going to find what I've been searching for from that old mode, because that old mode was to keep me from experiencing love, to keep me from finding joy and happiness. And so that's what Eckhart's teaching, that's what the mystics and saints through the ages have been focusing on, the present moment, and literally that now is all that we have. In quantum, that's true. When you click the toggle switch, you go, wow, it's really true. Right now is all that I've got. And when you're back in Newtonian, you've got the guilt and collective mistakes of the past, and you've got the worries and concerns of the future. And right away, it's a slower gear. It's a downgrade to go to go Newtonian. It's a huge upgrade. It's going vertical when you shift to quantum. It's a new way of thinking. It's a new way of perceiving. You will never look at relationships the same way. You will never look at anything in the world the same way from this quantum perspective. It's where it's at.